After 7 weeks in lockdown, Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern has set out a three-step roadmap for Auckland to carefully move out of level three restrictions into level two. At step one, people now can connect with loved ones outdoors with no more than two households at a time and up to a maximum of 10 people. People can also move around Auckland for recreation, such as beach visits and hunting, while early learning centres can reopen for all. Face coverings should still be worn when going out, and keeping a safe distance is vital. While welcoming the changes, Pasifika health professionals remain cautious.
Spread is less likely in outdoors. And also COVID is less likely to spread in preschool children. So, you know, I think it's reasonable, allowing us a little bit more freedom, but still restricting movements and working and, you know, trying to keep us safe.
I was concerned about the possibility of a surge in the numbers because of the availability of mixing with other bubbles. I know they've tried to make it outdoors and limit of 10 people, but you know, if there was one unvaccinated, slightly infected person at one, when the next bubble meets with a different bubble the next day, there's just this potential to spread.
Well, I thought the Prime Minister was dancing on the head of a pin. It's very difficult, and I really feel for her. She's trying to balance business people, tired Aucklanders who wants freedom, as well as people like me who wants to continue to protect public health. So it's very difficult.
And Cabinet will review each step weekly to ensure it's safe to move before confirming the next step. Further south in the Waikato, one of the region's main Pacific community health providers has been keeping busy this past week. Staff from the Kaute Pasifika Trust have been operating a drive-through vaccination clinic in Boundary Road and plan to move to a more permanent site at the Richmond Street car park on Monday. The Pacific Hub for Health, Education, Employment and Social Services has been running vaccination clinics since June, but matters have taken on greater urgency in the past week following news of community cases in Hamilton and Raglan. The Waikato is at alert level 3 and its southern border was extended on Friday.